Well, hello, folks. Welcome to Healthy Hearing Loss. My name is Dee Dee, and we are going to talk about five questions that you need to ask yourself before you buy a stethoscope. Before we get to the video, I have to apologize. I have a cold, and so I might sound a little nasally. I might mess up my pronunciation because it's stuffy, you know, but I am negative for COVID. Woo! So let's get on to this. Topic number one is type of hearing aid fit. Do you have a open or closed hearing aid fit? That's going to be super important before you consider buying a stethoscope. I wish I had covered this topic prior to this video, but I'm covering it now. Hearing aids can be classified into two groups. You have the in the ear and behind the ear. I do need to disclose that I am not an audiologist or an otolaryngologist. I am a medical professional that works in a primary care setting, but I have not specialized in audiology. However, I have had hearing loss since the age of two, so I have a little bit of knowledge. So going forward, after we go through all of these questions, and I'll remind you over and over that you need to visit your audiologist. They are your cheerleaders. They should be your cheerleaders. They want to see you be successful with your hearing, and they have a lot of knowledge that we don't have because that's what they specialize in, and they have lots of training. I mean, they have a doctorate degree in audiology. Super important to talk to your audiologist. Now, getting back to the fitting. Sound has to get into our ears through the ear canal. And one way to do this is the behind the ear. When you have a hearing aid that goes in the back and it's connected and it goes all the way through, on the other end, it could be either an ear mold, or it can be a foam tip, or even a silicone dome, in which all of those are known as receivers. And they are customized to your hearing level and comfort, mostly to diminish as much of the occlusive effect that many of us might feel. Now, the occlusive effect, I mean, I think about like just putting my hand against my ear, and you get a little bit of suction. When I'm talking, my voice is very like kind of hollow, and it's even worse when you have a cold. With my experience, I only know closed fit because of the level of my hearing loss. And I benefit from the increase of low frequency sounds. I'm going to give you an example of closed fit hearing aids or closed fitted hearing aids or hearing aid fitted. This is an old hearing aid. I'm going to say this hearing aid is over 15 years old. Now, this is a pretty big hearing aid. I have a behind the ear portion of it right here, and it's connected to a tube that goes to an ear mold. This ear mold is pretty spiffy because it has a little like handle on there that I could easily take it out of my ear. It was probably one of my favorite ear molds because not only if it, you know, looked like skin, I mean, the old ones I have, my God, you should see my old ones. The hearing aid itself was probably twice as big. The mold was like this god-awful tan color, dark tan color. Oh, I can't even remember. It was so hideous. It was gross. I'm glad I don't have to wear those anymore. I don't even have to wear this type anymore because technology is fantastic. The next hearing aid I had prior to the ones that I currently wear were the Cross. And again, it was made by Phonak. I have a little smaller one, super small compared to this guy. But the difference is it goes to a wire. I don't know if you can see it there. And then it goes to the in-canal hearing aid portion, and it's molded to my ear. Both of these have very, very tiny vents in them to help with some of the occlusion effect, but very minimal. I still get it no matter what. I'll always have it because of my hearing loss level. The next one I'm going to show you, I'm going to pretend that this is a in-the-ear receiver or a hearing aid that has a tip on it. It's got the same behind the ear portion. You're going to imagine that this is a wire going to the very end to a dome. Now, they have different ones that are domed that are closed and open. That's when you have to ask your audiologist what you have, because I have no idea. This is not even a real hearing aid. This is a receiver for my other hearing aid. So when I wear these, all the information on this side goes through the receiver and sends it to my hearing aid, and then I get all the sound into my ear canal. This is a different system, but you can kind of see why one would be open and one would be closed. You have the occlusion of that, and then you have open with that little open in the end. When you go to a stethoscope manufacturer's website, they will recommend or even say that it's mandatory to use their stethoscope with either an open fit or closed fit a certain way. An open fit, you're not going to do well with using the hearing aid as a way of hearing your stethoscope. It just doesn't work very well because it doesn't give you the full effect in the ear because it's open. However, when somebody has a closed fit like myself, I can use my hearing aid very well because there's nothing going to interfere with the sound going through my ear canal. We're going to get into specifics of this, but I'm going to put a link in the description below to Think's Lab little chart or table. On the right side, it will tell you what they recommend that you can or can't use with that hearing aid. Topic number two, anatomy of the stethoscope. I'm not going to talk about the history. It was made back in 18-something-something by somebody, whatever, and they used a big cone. No, I'm not going to talk about that. Traditional stethoscope. Earpieces connect to two tubings on each side, goes to a long tubing, and the very end has the chest piece. Simple, easy. I'm going to put a link below to an anatomy diagram of the actual anatomy of the stethoscope. It was put out by Littman and it's a PDF. I would suggest you take a look at that so you have a full understanding what a stethoscope does. I'm going to show you my first traditional stethoscope. It is way over 20 years old. This was it. Now, I used this stethoscope for a long time. It is a Littman Cardiology 3. As you can tell, it doesn't even have a diaphragm on the side, whatever. It's really old. It's cracking. I could get a new tubing and use this, but this is my old stethoscope I use. If you have mild hearing loss, you can get away with a traditional stethoscope. I just want to point out that the earpiece themselves, depending on what type of hearing aid you have, if you have a closed-fit hearing aid, there is no air going into your ear most of the time, and it will get moist in there. So when you bring in a tip that is soft like this, and when you put it in your ear, it creates a vacuum, and that is going to be the occlusion effect with the earpiece. So either you keep the ear canal clean and dry, or you get a hard tip at the end of the earpiece. That was one thing I learned a long, long time ago. I wouldn't use this traditional stethoscope anymore because I can't. Traditional stethoscopes do not work for me. Nope, not with my severe to profound sensory neural hearing loss. I will say back in the day when I was working my early years as a paramedic, I had moderate to severe hearing loss and I was able to get away with a little bit of the traditional, but then I had to increase to electronic. And that's what we're going to talk about, electronic. Amplified stethoscope. I have heard people use electronic and digital interchangeably, but they are completely two different stethoscopes. But I can definitely see why it's confusing and I'll tell you why. Now the electronic stethoscope utilizes advanced technology to overcome the low sounds of a traditional stethoscope and helps you amplify body sounds. Amplified stethoscopes are electronic and typically run on batteries. Now I'm going to talk about my first electronic stethoscope, amplified, and here it is. It's a pretty old one as well. It's the very first one I ever owned. This is probably, 15 years old as well. And you can see that it just has some dials that go up and down. And then it has this diaphragm on this side and the bell on this side. And it ran on batteries, but you had to take the batteries out by taking this little screw out and changing the batteries. So I always carried batteries with me everywhere I went or wherever I was working. And you can tell on this one, because I can only hear in my right ear, I had a hard tip on this side. It's all busted up, but that's what worked for me. It's hard versus the soft. And I was able to pick up sounds pretty well when I had moderate to severe hearing loss. That is an electronic amplified. It just turns up the sound so that I can hear better. This is Littman 3000 model. The newest one has the digital face on it. Now that's where it can get confusing. Somebody says, I have an amplified stethoscope, but it has a digital screen. So now you're thinking that it is an amplified electronic digital stethoscope. Think the way you want to. But if you just have this with no digital aspect of it, it's just an electronic amplified stethoscope. Now getting on to the digital stethoscope, I always say digital with an N, digital. It's hard to do it with your cold. I can't hear myself. Now, the digital stethoscope converts the audio sound into a digital signal. My first video that I posted back in 2018 was on the Think Lab stethoscope. And I've showed this several times before in my other videos. I've had this thing probably about 10 years now, and I absolutely love this thing. But I needed to use my T-coil with a streamer, which is covered by sort of this fabric to make it a little bit more fun when I was around kids and didn't make it look so techy looking. And then I wrap it around my neck and do it that way. So that was my first digital stethoscope. There was a time I checked out another one, and this one was the StethiPoint. Has not only can you hear the sound, it's wireless, it goes Bluetooth, but it also has tactile, so you could feel the vibration on it. I have not used this since I bought it. I tried it for like a week and I put it off. For some reason, just didn't get back into using it. So I'm not going to cover it on here because I know nothing but other than the fact that it has audio sounds and tactile. Because I was curious about doing more of a visual representation of heart sounds, I wanted to try another stethoscope. And of course, this is the core stethoscope. It looks like a traditional stethoscope, and it is. The earpieces going to your ears. Has tubes that go down all the way to the earpiece, which has a bell and a diaphragm. That is an analog, a traditional stethoscope. The neat thing about this is that you can turn on this toggle here with the light turning on, and now you have the volume on here going up and down. That would be your amplification. That would be your amplified electronic stethoscope. And then from there, you download the Eko app onto the phone and you get the digital part of it. So this is a traditional, electronic, amplified, and digital. And off note, I'd like to mention that all the stethoscopes that are electronic or digital is considered an assistive listening device for medical professionals with hearing loss. Okay, we covered all those. Traditional, electronic, which is the same thing as amplified, and digital. And then you notice that the last one they talked about had all of them. In the description below, I'm going to put that comparison chart from Ample, the Associations of Medical Professionals with Hearing Loss. They did a great comparison chart, and that's in the description below. So please check that out. Let's go on to number three, stethoscope features. I'm going to put these questions on the screen. Do you want to listen to sounds using one sense? And what does that mean? You're hearing. You just want to hear through your stethoscope. So asking yourself that question is going to help you determine which stethoscope you want. Next question. Are you looking to use two or three senses? That means audio, visual, or tactile. All of those used to confirm what you actually hear. It's a kind of a confidence thing. That's going to be another question you want to answer. Next question. Do you want to be able to see tracings for heart sound, also known as the phonocardiogram? I've done videos on the Littman Core Eko here, and you can watch that later. We're not finished yet. I'll put it in the description below. Let's get on to the next question. How about an EKG tracing? And this video had talked about the DUO. If you want to watch that, I'll link it below. But that gives you that little tracing if that's something that's interesting to you. Those are important questions to ask yourself before considering buying a stethoscope. Let's get on to number are we on now? All right, number four, appearance. What do you want or don't want in regards to the appearance of the stethoscope? Does the traditional professional look of a stethoscope being around your neck appeal to you? Like if you're a medical doctor, nurse practitioner, PA, or a registered nurse, you may like the look of a stethoscope being around you, but you might even also like it. You like the feel feel of it around you, knowing that it's there all the time. Not so much just about the look, it's about knowing you have it. Or do you want to have a stethoscope that can fit in your pocket? Do you care about the color? Do you want to use black, silver, white, maybe a rainbow chest piece? Like, I put this cloth around the cable coming from my ThinkLab stethoscope because I didn't want to be very techy. So is that something you would be worried about? Okay, number five, accessories. So first, let's talk about budget. You want to ask yourself a couple of things about budget. How much money do you have? What's the least amount that you can pay? What's the arranged? Is it $100? Is it $200 to $300? Or is it $400 or more? Knowing what your budget is and how much you're willing to pay is going to help you say, I can't afford it, can't go there, but let's find a different option and just figure it out that way. Another thing you might want to think about, if you are somebody who has money for reimbursement for like conferences or something, if you didn't go to a conference, can you use that money to buy a new stethoscope? I've seen medical professionals do that, and I think I'm going to try too, especially with the next stethoscope that I'm going to try, the new one that I've never heard of, and I want to try it. And if I like it, then I'll do a review here on my channel. But until then, stay tuned. Make sure you hit that notification if you want to know about that. You also want to think about the battery life and all that kind of stuff. Like I said, if you go to the ThinkLab little chart there that says open and closed fitted, then it's going to give you an idea of what you need for accessories. Let's start off. Are you going to be just using the earpiece of the stethoscope? You have mild hearing loss and you don't need to buy anything other than just use the stethoscope. But what if you need to use headphones? Are you going to get the direct audio input, meaning you have to have a cord that goes into the stethoscope, very much like the ThinkLab stethoscope? You would put a headphone right into the jack. Or are you going to use a stethoscope that can use wireless earbuds? Are you want wireless or do you want the direct audio input? I do not use headphones or earbuds. I use my hearing aids through my Bluetooth or streamer. Lots to talk about. After your research and you've come up with, I think this may work, have that conversation with the audiologist so they can determine and help you to see if that stethoscope would be best for you. And it's all going to be based on your kind of the hearing loss, degree, level, all that stuff. Cannot stress that enough, is to have a conversation with the audiologist. I will inform you that a lot of audiologists, or many of them, may not have any knowledge of stethoscope. They will actually be learning from you. So the more that we can get to audiologists and educate them, and they can use their education to kind of help us get the hearing aid and stethoscope we want, that is teamwork. That is that person-centered relationship that you want to create and develop with your audiologist. One last thing I want to say, we covered five top questions that you need to ask. Let's review them real quick here. I think it's important. Number one, type of hearing aid fit. Number two, anatomy of the stethoscope. Number three, stethoscope features. Number four, appearance. Number five, accessories. I want to remind people that, you know, a lot of manufacturers for stethoscopes have sales going on the Core Echo website, that they have a lot of sales, especially during holidays. We have one, I think it's till the 19th, so this, I don't think this video will be up by then, but make sure you look on their website to see if they have any sales going on so it will be cheaper down the road for you. Okie dokie, folks. I think that's going to wrap it up. And all right, thanks for stopping by. Catch you later. Bye.